Mosaic, a daily news program from Link TV, presents a selection of news reports from independent and state-controlled broadcasters from throughout the Middle East.
There was a suicide attack with a booby-trapped car this morning at a checkpoint leading to the party office of the Prime Minister Iyad Allawi. Two people were killed and at least 10 others were injured in one of the attacks carried out by armed men before the elections next Sunday. The explosion shook central Baghdad and smoke was seen rising above the site of the attack. The Zarqawi group claimed responsibility, promising to carry out more attacks.
Once again, the residents of Baghdad woke up to the sound of explosions. On Zaytoun Street in western Baghdad, a suicide bomber drove a booby-trapped car into a security checkpoint, exploding himself in an operation most likely targeting the office of the National Accord Party, headed by the interim Iraqi Prime Minister Iyad Allawi.
I came in the morning to sell food for the Eid. As soon as I came here, I saw an explosion caused by a car that came suddenly. We don't know who was behind the incident. We saw shrapnel. It must be someone with bad intentions. The incident happened between 8 and 9 in the morning. In the area right across from you, an ambulance came from near the fence and transported the injured. The traffic came to a halt, no people or cars. There were only United States soldiers, emergency forces, and the police.
The explosion wounded some 10 people, 7 of whom were Iraqi policemen. Most of them transferred to the Yarmouk Hospital. Meanwhile, a police car was seen totally destroyed. Immediately after the explosion, U.S. forces brought in reinforcements for the Iraqi National Guard, cordoning off the area. These developments appeared to clearly cause panic among the Iraqi and U.S. forces. Many times, members of the Iraqi National Guard would fire randomly in the air to disperse the citizens. Meanwhile, the media was prohibited from nearing the site of the incident. This operation came the day after a website broadcast an audio message from Abu Musab al-Zarqawi, condemning the Shi'i celebration surrounding the elections, and urged the Sunni groups, according to the tape, to carry out a holy war against them. As fear increases over whether the elections will deteriorate into an electoral bloodbath due to the increased intensity of explosive operations,